also relaxant properties that are used in veterinary medicine. It is used to calm and facilitate the handling of a variety of animal species, including cattle, sheep, and horses, as well as to perform diagnostic and surgical procedures, relieve pain, and act as a local anesthetic. Philadelphia, xylazine began to gain popularity in the mid-2010s. People who used and sold drugs alleged that xylazine had become a highly sought-after substance and that it has become a much more common component of the local drug supply. Reports from Philadelphia, as well as hints that xylazine was appearing in other parts of the country, prompted the researchers and colleagues to try to track the drug's spread across the continental United States. Xylazine was found in 0.36% of overdose deaths in 2015, according to research. It increased to 6.7% by 2020. It was found in 1 out of every 5 overdose deaths in some areas. Notably, the study discovered fentanyl, a powerful synthetic opioid that has come to dominate regional drug supplies in nearly every xylazine-related death, indicating that it wasn't just a Many people on the outside believe that substance abuse is a bad choice in which someone should have said no, bad habit that just needs to be kicked, weakness that someone can't overcome the withdrawal symptoms, and moral failing that the person has given up. In reality, drug addiction is none of the above. It is a chronic brain disease that cannot be cured with a simple no or change of mind. It is critical to recognize this before asking, why do people become addicted to drugs? Or why did my child become addicted to drugs? More than likely, you may have additional questions such as, how did this happen? Your loved ones may have been properly raised with a strong moral foundation or in a good home, but they can still begin using drugs. The truth is that people use drugs for a variety of reasons, and they become addicted for a variety of reasons. It is critical that for the individual not to blame themselves or the loved one before you have thoroughly investigated the situation. As concerned family members, we frequently wonder, why do some people become addicted to drugs while others not? This is a valid question, and many drug users don't believe they'll become addicted. The truth is that anyone can become addicted to drugs, and there are a variety of factors that make them more vulnerable. The following are some of the most common risk factors or potential causes of drug addiction. 1. Early life stressors, such as being abused or witnessing trauma. 2. Abuse, either physical or sexual, in the past. 3. Genetic vulnerability, such as other family members who struggle with addiction. 4. Prenatal alcohol or drug exposure while in the womb. 5. Lack of parental supervision or monitoring during adolescence, peer pressure from friends or social circles, or association with drug-using peers. Mental health disorders such as depression and anxiety. A person's susceptibility to addiction can be influenced by a combination of genetic and environmental factors. Genetics, according to the National Institute on Drug Abuse, accounts for roughly half of a person's likelihood of developing an addiction. As a result, environmental risk factors such as stress, trauma, It alters. When the brain is exposed to this on a regular basis, it becomes reliant on the feel-good behavior. As a result, it hardwires those euphoric drug-using experiences into its circuitry, and drug use becomes its top priority. These are physical changes that will occur. The brain's reward system, a primitive system that exists to ensure we seek what we need, becomes hardwired to prioritize drug use over all. even when the drugs no longer provide pleasure to the user, which happens over time as the user becomes tolerant to them, the brain continues to push this need. It causes intense craving in the same part of the brain as the survival instinct. As a result, acting on these cravings, i.e. using drugs, becomes an overwhelming and desperate need. At the same time that the brain's reward system is affected, the parts of the brain responsible for judgment, decision-making, learning, and self-control are also affected. Despite the fact that drug addiction causes physical and chronic changes in the brain, there is good news.